How to create a simple automation project using the M340 Discovery Kit. The trainee will be able to create a simple automation project using the M340 Pack and Unity Pro software. The Discovery Kit contains all of the hardware components for the application, as well as the Unity Pro engineering software. This video gives an overview for the creation of a simple automation project using the M340 Pack Discovery Kit and Unity Pro engineering software. The full project instructions and project files for importing can be found in the startup guide within the Discovery Kit electronic files. Inside the Discovery Kit you will find the following items: 4 slot mounting backplane, power supply, pack processor with memory card, mixed input and output module, pre-wired connection cable, Telefast simulation module, programming cable, Telefast power supply connection wires. Mount the pack modules on the mounting backplane with a power supply inserted in the leftmost slot of the rack, followed by the processor, and finally the mixed input and output module. Connect the Telefast simulation module to the I/O module using the pre-wired connection cable. Connect the simulation module power supply inputs to the power supply module output. And finally, connect the power supply inputs to a mains supply of 100 to 240 VAC. Launch the Unity Pro program. Set the PLC address. Click on PLC in the menu bar. Click on Set Address. Enter SYS in address field of the PLC zone. Select USB in the media field. Confirm by clicking OK. Create a new project by clicking on the New Project button. Double-click on the BMXP3420302 pack and the Unity Pro user interface will now appear. Double-click the PLC bus and then double-click on the rack. Select the BMXXBP0400 rack and click OK. Double-click the slot 1 position of the rack. Expand the discrete selection box and select the BMXDDM16022IO module. The I/O for this application will be imported from the project files. However, the first discrete input needs to be declared manually. Double-click on the BMXDDM16022 module in the bus editor. Then click on the node in the top left-hand corner. Within the I/O Objects tab, select the %i and %q check boxes. Click on Update Grid. Select the line for input %i 0.1.0 and enter badge inserted in the prefix or name field and input badge inserted in the comment field. Click on Create. The variables for this application are able to be entered one at a time manually, alternatively they can be imported from a .xsy file. For the purposes of this demonstration we will import them from the project files. Before importing the variables, the first variable needs to be manually declared. Double-click on the variables and FB instances directory in the project browser, select the first available line. Enter init in the name field and select ebool in the type field. Enter sets the garage to the init step in the comment field. Right-click on the variables and FB instances directory in the project browser. Click on the import command. Save the project. Select the .xsy file type. Browse to the file location of variables XSY on the downloaded project files. Click on the Import button. Click on the Keep All button and OK. The variables are now imported into your application. The functional part of the program is going to be completed by importing the required sections and derived function blocks, or DFBs, from the project files. To import the garage management section, right-click on Sections and select Import. Click Yes to save changes. Select the XLD file type and browse to the location of the project files, which contains the file garage management with DFB. Click Import. When the Import Trouble Report screen appears, click on Replace All and click OK. The garage management section is now imported into the program. To view this section, then click on the directory in the project browser. To import the door management DFB, right-click on the derived FB types directory and select Import. Click Yes to save changes. On the Import dialog box, select the XDB file type and browse to the DFB door management file in the project files. Click Import. Click on Replace All and click OK. To view the section, click the derived FB types directory in the project browser. To import the car counting section of the program, right-click on the sections directory of the project browser and select the import command. Click Yes to save changes. Select the XST file type and browse to the car counting XST file in the project files. Click Import and replace all on the import trouble report. Click OK to confirm. To view this section, double-click the car counting directory in the project browser. To import the operator screen, right-click operator screens and click on Import. Select Yes to save changes. Select the file type runtime screen and browse to the garage control file in the project files. To create the animation table, right-click on the animation tables directory in the project browser and select New Animation Table. Enter animation in the properties window, and click OK. Double-click the variables and FB instances directory in the project browser. Sort the variable by clicking on the address column to group the inputs and the outputs. Select all of the inputs and outputs by pressing Ctrl A and press Ctrl C. Double-click the animation table in the project browser. Select the first row and press Ctrl V. All of the inputs and outputs are now displayed in the animation table. Using the USB connection cable, connect the computer to the programming port of the PAC. After making sure that Unity Pro is in standard mode, click on the Connect button. Note, if the computer will not connect to the PAC, then check the Unity Pro Help menu. Click on the Download Project button and check the PLC Run After Transfer box. In the Transfer Project to PLC box, click Rebuild All and Transfer and then OK to run the PAC. The application will now transfer to the PLC. The developed application is now being executed by the PLC. To simulate the application, you will use Unity Pro commands to control the execution of the application, the Telefast module to activate the three inputs, the operator screen to view the garage status and car positions, and finally the animation table to view the status of every input/output. The car counter, and to see if the garage is full. When in run mode, the PLC will execute the application. If the run icon is grayed out, the PLC is in run mode. To change to stop mode, click on the stop icon. To return to run mode, simply click on the run icon and confirm OK in the dialog box. The first three switches on the Telefast module control the three inputs for the system: badge inserted, entry sensor, and exit sensor. Move the switch to the right-hand position to enable the input. To access the operator screen, open the operator screen's directory in the project browser and double-click on the garage control item. Maximize the screen to see a larger view. You will need to use the buttons Reset Number of Cars and INIT System. To access these buttons, click on the Enable Right Variable icon in the toolbar. To initialize the system, click on the INIT System button of the operator screen. The door closing output will be activated for 10 seconds and then the door will be closed. Switch on the badge inserted input by moving the Telefast module channel 0 toggle switch to the right and then switch off again. A car will appear at the entrance to the garage and the door will open 10 seconds after the input is switched on. The car is now able to enter the garage. Switch on the car entry sensor input by moving the channel 1 switch to the right to simulate the car having reached the entry to the garage. Move the channel 1 switch to the center position to simulate the car having moved past the entry point. Switch on the car exit sensor by moving the channel 2 toggle switch to the right to simulate the car moving past the garage door. The door will now close after 10 seconds. The number of cars counter has changed to 1. Move the channel 2 toggle switch to the center to simulate the car moving past the garage exit point and parking in an empty space. Repeat the last three steps to simulate additional cars entering the garage and note the car counter incrementing each time. To simulate a car leaving the garage, move the channel 2 toggle switch to the right. The garage door will now open. Move the channel 2 toggle switch back to the center position once the garage door is open. Move the channel 1 toggle switch to the right to simulate the car having reached the entry point to the garage. Note the garage door will now close. Move the channel 1 switch to the center position to simulate the car having left the garage. Note the number of cars counter decrements after each car has left. Now you've created a simple automation project using the M340 Discovery Kit. Thank you for watching. For further information, please visit www.schneider-electric.com or contact your local Schneider Electric representative.